G'day guys, glad to be back. And we are here on Streets, one of Hinkle's new maps, to watch a competitive 2v2 game. We've got J-Dudes on the Japanese team and Biba on the Hungarian team. And on the opposing side, we have the guys from Finland, Mr. Pringles and Arcturus. Dual wielding French Finnish men. That's a mouthful. And I don't like to say a mouthful when I'm talking about men. And please ignore me, that was a bit of Greek in me. Sorry, a bit of Greek influence. Anyway, we have Bubo in the center with a soul squad going with the purposes. Gonna meet Arcturus perhaps, maybe not. Arcturus is actually avoiding that side, going southern and eastern. And on the right side we have J-Dudes with a regular squad. Gonna meet Pringles in the open field. Pringles has no cover on his side, he's gonna prone straight down. And J-Dudes with a nice, sneaky rifleman from the back, perhaps gets a grenade off. Very nicely placed, but only takes out one. Then where's that MG of J-Dudes? It's deciding not to show itself. Where is it? It's gone. The MG, oh there it is, okay. Some reason when it was climbing up doesn't actually show itself. But a wonderful position. Looks marvelous shooting down onto the ground from up top. I guess it isn't very, very nicely covered. You can see it's very open windmill. But it has a nice view of the action, and it can shoot down anywhere, I guess it can shoot down on cover. It's done okay, so it looks like J-Dudes has actually won that with the regular squad opening. And also, because of that, now Pringles has the majority though on the center of the Western Northern, or the center between the center and Western Northern. And that's the reason why a regular squad, regular squad can win one area, but here comes a rare assault squad from J-Dudes. And we shall try to get into the cover. Pringles also sending a resistance squad. Finding it quite interesting to see, oh nice prone, micro there, takes out one. And the resistance squad storming in, but will get totally outshot I believe by this assault squad. Assault squad decides to walk back a bit just in case the grenade comes. Pringles with a grenade, and oh, nothing. I think that resistance squad is going to get totally outshot now. Type 100 should have no problem whatsoever. So nice hold by J-Dude. Center still held by Booba. Not much happening. Arcturus is actually just holding his positions. Ah. He went the elite marksman squad, I think. No, he didn't. He went a regular squad. Okay. So interesting to see what combos can be made. Not sure why they went dual French. Perhaps they had some own reasonings, as they do. Good old Char-2C, World War One tank, pretty much decommissioned in World War One. Same as that nice little FD-17. As slow as that, but pretty much the polar opposites in terms of size. So big boy, small boy, no matter what, those French old tanks are damn slow. Just like Mr. Pringles and Arcturus like it, slow and steady, big and small. That doesn't sound very good either. What is going on? We've been hanging around the wrong type of people these days. So, oh, nice. Hotchkiss takes out the Cispa. Oh, sorry, not the Cispa, it's called the Chubba. Excuse my Hungarian. That's assault squad on the right. Keeping the flow up very nicely by J-Dudes, but now this Hotchkiss is going to start mowing down all those Jappies. And there's not going to be a counter for some time because I think he just lost that. I believe that was J-Dudes' tank, but let's see this Char-2C in action. It's actually an SPG tank, haven't seen it too often. And it shoots HEs in arc, pretty decent armor. But otherwise, not a great tank, but a very cheap tank. Because it's pretty much bound for the antique shop. Oh, grenade! Boom! I think he doesn't know that's actually a HE lobbing tank. Maybe he does, I don't know. Perhaps he just wants to use it aggressively. It does have quite a lot of crew. I believe it has 10 crew inside. 10 crew. Look at the MG. And that is why. Blaze away, Frenchman. Or French, what do you call 10 French people? You can't call them a group, sounds like a large group, a gang. A gang of Frenchmen coming to the center. I haven't been playing much at all in the last month, so good luck to Handyz in the next tournament. He's certainly going to have a sore back carrying me to the eventual loss, which I'm expecting. I'm definitely not going to be playing very well. It's time for the new players to win tournaments. You know, I'm old enough. I'm happy to just stay behind the lines casting. I've had my fair share of glory. Oh, let's see. Oh wow, look at that MG just takes it on the side. This is a very interesting vibe from Lactose. I like it. It actually is working as well with its infantry support capabilities at MGs, but he's still not capping the center. Arcturus moving in a bit more. No support yet from infantry. A Chi Heart to counter the Hotchkiss did work very well. Nicely played by J Dudes, and still holding on to three flags, 22-0 for the J Dudes and Booba team. So, yeah, obviously they're playing the alliances, and I do find it interesting that people still choose the same nations when they can have the options of going two nations, where I think one nation can be the specialist, or one nation can fill the gap that the other nation does not have. With going the same nation, I think their thinking is, I suppose, yeah, they could either mix up the special points, but they can have stronger timers, as in some things come out exactly at the same time, and they can push that power more. I mean, you know what I mean. By buying the same thing at the same time, it'll be even more powerful. What's this? Is that resistance? I don't remember. That's an assault squad, okay. Yes, the reason I've been playing, replays have been broken. It's just been fixed on the 11th of July, I think. So I'm not sure when this video will be uploaded, but yep. What's fixed then? So hopefully I can cast more. There's been a lot more replays put in, and wow, nice play by Mr. Pringles buying a two-pointer. That's a two-pointer 13th Demi Brigade, which is the Foreign Legion, the elite Foreign Legion, coming in an engineer truck. And they've come in quite spectacularly onto the northern western point without any sort of interference. Chi-Ha, though, could have quite easily HC'd that and exploded that Renault engineering truck and all those little Frenchmen inside. And now it's all the French guys are outside, except maybe the driver. Poor driver, let's see, blow, boom! There goes the driver. Any debris gonna land on any Foreign Legion? No, lucky. That, Mr. Pringle's giving a bit of a taste of his own medicine. The Frenchman using the Japanese windmill tactic as J-Dudes. Oh, wow, 2 round 3 techs at the chart to see. Sorry, guys, didn't miss that. But you can see now the hundreds of tank crew coming out of the chart to see. And that was done by the 2 round 3, the famous 2 round 3, 75mm, 80mm turret, 80mm hull. Definitely the Panzer H on steroids, as you can say. And here is Mr. Pringles with the one-pointer resistance. Gorilla. And they're sneaking in Panzer. He's sticking in the Panzerfaust guys. Come to the few of them. And I must say they have quite fine taste in fashion. You can see these French guys. Flannel shirt, a bit red in color. They wear it proudly into battle. One might get through, but this guy is definitely spotted. It's a 1-pointer special 80 infantry as well. Very cool to see, interesting buys. A lot's going on, but let's take a look at this shot by Pringles of the Panzerfaust. Resistance, boom, misses, and yes, that's a one-star resistance. Another one for Pringles sticking up. I think caught napping here, Mr. JDs, not watching the position. Here it comes. Let's see this. Boom, tracked again, and tracked for the first time, unless he hit something, but bad luck to him. And what's over here? We've got the Char B1 Tur. Very nice. The Tur. That. There's a few varieties of Char. Let's just switch over. This is fixed, by the way. You can switch teams, I believe. Hopefully the latest patch didn't break that. The Char Tur comes with extra armor. Then the Char B1. Char B1 Revolver has a revolver gun which shoots really fast in succession. And six rounds in succession. Very fast, then a reload. So that's, that's pretty much the French heavy tanks, the Chars. They just pretty much upgraded them here and there. not known for the heavies, but 2 round 3 is going to be a hard one to counter in the center. but doing very good with the Foreign Legion. Interesting. Interesting to see them used very well. Also the mortar in the back here, the one special pointer 81mm branch. And the Foreign Legion. Haven't really seen them work, I guess when I was playing the mod about 2 months ago. I haven't played for ages. Definitely be watching intently to see any balance issues that may arise. Chiha is coming in with not much support. There's one MG home guard guy and one Foreign Legion guy, which definitely has an AT grenade. Oh, this could be a nasty one. Oh, it's actually getting shot at from the side from the Char B1 Tur. And what is it trying? This Chiha's definitely, pretty much. He's trying to take on a giant there. He's like a little ant trying to take on that Tur. It's not in a million years he'll be able to penetrate that that tank. Regardless, side or the rear, back to the front, up and down. And that wasn't very good description as well. Sorry guys. And I just like to say Greek just casting it for Greek basically. So pretty much he likes those type of jokes. Imagino Arty, 4 special point, GPF, or 3 special points, I think it is. So he's bringing out the Arty now. That's a 3 special pointer, obviously, I just said that. And J-Dude is going to try to rout out that Foreign Legion, and has done so. Was the grenade finish off with the MG. On the left-hand side, people with a Toldy Eye, 20mm pounding away. Also, just want to give some random words of advice to you young people watching. I know a lot of you young guys travel. Just want to say, get travel insurance if you are traveling. This is a... Sniper! Got taken out by a Type 2 SMG. Nasty. JD's AT Infantry. What a nice play. JD's playing so well. Has taken out the Tur and that, and has capped the two flags. Pringles now with a 4 special points. Not 4 special points, that's a 4th tier. Oh, nasty. Takes out the... That's the mechanized squad. A bit rusty, haven't cast it for 10 years. Mechanized saboteurs. Interesting, French squad comes with less men and a smaller half-track, but slightly cheaper. Yeah, there's a more extreme variety of the mechanized with the Italians, which actually come with even more less men, a smaller half-track, but a lot of Panzerfaust, which make it a good rating under-hill unit. So, otherwise, all the other mechanized are pretty much similar. Toldy Eyes, been taken out. Try to rush that howitzer. Both of them going to howitzers, Pringles and... Oh, nice, he's taking out the gun. But here's the Char B1 Terror. What's it trying to do? It's going to try play toe-to-toe with the Turan 3. Turan 3 will struggle to penetrate it, but vice versa. It will have the Tur has a pretty bad gun and will have absolutely no chance of penetrating. Nice move here. We have Booba recapping the point. Pretty fast-paced game, even though there's Arty involved. One prone guy from Arcturus is actually withstanding a few grenades. This map is actually also turning to be very good in terms of the flow in action. The towns aren't a complete lockdown fest, and it seems like the flanks are quite back and forth. No lockdown silly positions. And three flags coming up, and another mechanized squad from Mr. Pringles. Let's see how he fares. And on that insurance note, just please make sure you, if you are sponsoring anyone coming from overseas, that they do get insurance as well. Bren coming in. Oh, Shuka. I don't call this the Shuka. It's definitely the Shuka. Oh, grenade misses. That was interesting. Oh, Panzer Shrek. RPG. The Shukas haven't been surviving very long, but I guess that's not the purpose. Pringles just pretty much runs them in and takes them all out. And that's the Saboteur. It's pretty cheap, isn't it? 380. I think that's actually probably a bug, to be honest. I'm not sure if I increased the Saboteur price, or did I? Maybe I didn't. What's to come, I think. But nice elite troop calls by Pringles. Not actually working so far though. GPF, where's it firing at? It's firing onto the backfield at the type. Oh, 97 mortar has taken it out. Very well done. And it's done its job most definitely for the game. And damn it indeed. That's what? Is that UK troops? Interesting. Definitely have the wrong nationality attached to their breed, that troop breed. But Home Guard blazing down the right side. Pringles Assault Squad is out in the open and will get taken out eventually. There's a little bit of a stone wall kind of blocking the effectiveness. You can see the bullets traveling, hitting the stone wall, or some of them hitting the stone wall before hitting the troops. And this side being assaulted by the resistance. Ooh, some elite soldiers here, the MP28, SNLF, grenade, Molotov maybe. Oh, Type 92 coming in for some reason. Oh no, Molotov. Oh, lucky that hit some sort of bush and failed to kill anything, but wow, it's actually still alive. And oh wow, Piat is actually shooting at the engine and it's damaged, but yeah, if you keep shooting at the same place, it just stay damaged. And it did very well, in fact. It withstood a lot of the Piat shots. And J-Dudes is doing a fantastic job holding Mr. Pringles so far. Paratroopers coming in as well now from J-Dudes on the western flank. And a 25mm MLE. So yeah, all these guys are in the tournament. J-Dudes and Boober in their own team. And they look actually quite formidable, to be honest. They probably beat me and Handy since I'm so crap these days. And Pringles and Arcturus, I think then Arcturus isn't playing, but he might be. Mr. Pringles will be playing with Jutska, I think, but who knows? Who knows, because pretty much all the super players are sluts these days. Jutska's formed and reformed the team, closed it down, joined someone else, maybe three times, I don't know, I can't keep track, so I'm sure there'll be a lot of sleeping around before the actual tournament starts before we can see who is actually in what team, yeah, amongst the super players. So GPF not finding its mark, trying to get the home guard MGs that was so easily guarding the west side. No dice for that GPF. I just had a moment of panic there because I haven't recorded for a month that I didn't hit the record button. But in my, my intuition was right. Toldy. Oh, that's a repair Toldy. That must have been one that was trying to run over that howitzer. And unfortunately there's a part of this gun model where if it gets damaged, you can't repair it, which I'd say it's okay, because I kind of think this unit is slightly too good, and you can kind of imagine it as being, yeah, they don't have the spare parts of that World War One gun anymore, you just can't repair it. So there's a story behind that bug that makes it believable, so it's not a bug, guys. That's Strat 29 laziness happening. Not really. I would if I had time. Jutska has been modding recently, been spending a lot of time polishing and changing a few things. I know there's a lot I need to review though before I release it. I'm definitely going to be taking a good look, guys, so don't worry. It won't have all of his changes in at once. I'll make sure it's not full of any troll type units, which one-shots everything on the map from 10,000 range, like the far shot antics. And what the hell is that? Now I'm talking rubbish. Okay, let's check out this tur action. Ooh, look how slow that gun travels. Oh, such close range. It's gonna get its turret and gun destroyed first, I think. Oh, doesn't matter, it doesn't. It just gets hit in the front. Not angled. Right there. It's still alive and glitched. Oh, what's going on here? Is that main gun? Or tracked? That's tracked. Oh no, it's tracked in quite an awkward position. It's out in the open and can quite easily be flanked. 63-29. Wow, doing pretty good. Look at J-Dudes going all the way up. pushing towards the west. Turan 3, Bazooka. Yeah, I knew that was a sitting duck. Turus has taken nice advantage of that. With, what kind of unit is that? That, that's a part of the resist. He must have bought the Viva la Resistance, which comes with some OSS agents. He wants to destroy it. Second one, that has actually destroyed it completely. When flames come out. Oh, okay. Now that, it's definitely destroyed there, guys. I don't think anyone can put this back together. Not even all the king's horses and all the king's men. I've been watching some nursery rhymes because I have a child now. I am so sick of the Wiggles. I don't know if you heard of them. But I don't understand how you can watch the same song 100 times. That is my parenting advice. If you want your kids to shut up, put on the Wiggles. That was my plan. My original plan was never to allow him to watch TV. And that has totally changed because I can't handle the crying. And my second plan is not to allow him to play games so he can do some more productive things with his life. And I am guessing that's going to fail too, so I am not going to plan anymore, guys. I'm just going to just go with the flow. You've defeated me, child. That's pretty much what I'm saying. Just like I'll be defeated in this tournament very easily. Ooh. Boof. Love that Hungarian AT rifle. Unfortunately, the arrow cross AT rifle soldiers have both died. There is one the new. Yep. Oh no. Where is that AT rifle? Probably still on the guy. But Toldy cleaned up. As you can see in the mod, the 20mm still behaves the same way. The reason why is, yeah, I don't know about the knocking out effect, to be honest. It's going to change the gameplay way too much. And it's not something we're used to. And competitive players, it's about tradition here with competitive players. Had such many good tournaments in the past with that 20mm being the 20mm it is. It's 20mm is AS2. It's all about the 20mm. And taking away its one-shot capabilities just doesn't feel like AS2. Obviously in the mod it's balanced by price, so the real reason is because I just don't have time to test it, and also because the 20mm is balanced in the mod for one-shots, and I have to go through the whole balancing situation now, which I don't have knowledge of, because I have not played at the highest level with the 20mm, the new way. It makes sense. Anyway. Assault infantry storming from the left, and wow, this Buba and Jadu is looking very strong indeed. Let's see the Panzer Shrek from the elite. Oh, bam, hits its mark. He's got 3 or 4 stars. That's the 4th tier infantry of the Hungarians, and Foreign Legion coming in. Not going to be a cup of tea for them. They're going to be made into goulash right now. Ooh, nasty grenade, what's that? Boom, howitzer, bam. Not making much effect. What's actually been making the most effect? The Turan 3? Ooh, 1 GPF, I think that took out the mortar and some other big unit. Yeah, definitely a good unit to play versus Japan, I guess. And there's a Chabi 1 Tur. That's the same one that was glitched. So he got killed, I think, and it's been repaired now, unfortunately, for the French team. Let's see if they can come back. 23 minutes in, 87-29. The Foreign Legion have definitely made a need to goulash. Another flank as well from... Oh, J-Dude is on the southern east as well, pushing on. Pringles is stuck in his area now. He's helping Buba push a tourist into their spawn. They're not holding on to much, eh? They do have a stronghold in the center. Multiple MGs. What does we have? What do we have here? Whoa, what? Panzer G? And a Pan... Wow! Panzer G and H! This is cool! This is cool! They have gone... This is the first time I've seen this bot. They have gone 16th Panzer Army. And here they come. 5 special points for a Panzer G and a H. Plus some German infantry, I believe. Unfortunately, we got tankery by something. That. Oh, Vickers! Oh, taken out! by the tur, and maybe might not be a unit that will work, but especially with the 93 Vickers out. What says all the descriptions missing? I've definitely got descriptions on these units. Another assault. Ooh, let's see this Pringles clear up. He's got the Shukar. Arturus had one as well. But Panzer Shrek must have taken it out or something. Or maybe it was the Panzer G. Oh, it's the AT rifle. I can hear it blazing. Boom. Boom. There it is. Boom. Half track, no chance. Arturus didn't communicate to Pringles that there was this AT rifle there. Boom. Look at that blow. Oh, Arturus's one actually probably just got decrewed because it's now a crew back in game. But JD's filling the gap. Here comes the boom. Boom. Here comes the boom. With the Hungarian AT rifle. Just too epically strong. Totally penetrated that shoe. I didn't say penetrate that whole Greek, so please stop laughing. I miss Deus too. I really do. I miss casting, guys. Hopefully, you're happy that I'm back. I don't know, I feel like I'm making more jokes than usual, because maybe perhaps I've just been enjoying this a bit more, being my breakaway. Anyway, guys, hopefully it wasn't too bad. A bit rusty. Catch you around, hope to get more casual competitive games going, and then straight down to the tournament where you'll see me and Handsy fail on the voice comms, raging at each other. It'll be Handsy raging at me, pretty much. I'll be like, yep, I know, I'm shit. See you guys.